Greetings of the day. My name is Lakshman Jajwedi, Assistant Professor, GS College of Commerce, Padta. In this today's video of BCom 4th semester, we would discuss about the question related to the profit and loss account of Tripti Bank Private Limited, Tripti Bank Limited for the year ended on 31st of March 2003. Till earlier videos, we have seen the theoretical portion, the syllabus as well as pro forma of both P&L account and balance sheet. We have said that we have to perform in horizontal type. That is what we have discussed. The detailed theory as well as pro forma of all schedules plus profit and loss account plus balance sheet has been provided to you in your WhatsApp group. Link has been the PDF has been sent to you. Kindly refer to it for the purpose of detailed understanding of all the schedules. Now, for this video lecture, the link of the question is attached in the link of the in the video with the link in it on the in the what we can say drop down. आप उसको क्लिक करेंगे वहां से आप क्वेश्चन देख पाएंगे. आज हम यहाँ पे सॉल्यूशन पे बात करेंगे. तो एक शॉर्ट में क्वेश्चन के बारे में कहते हैं कि क्वेश्चन कहता है कि एक बैंक का आपको कुछ डिटेल्स दिए गए हैं, उसके साथ में ट्रायल बैलेंस के कुछ आइटम्स दिए गए हैं जो पी एंड एल अकाउंट से संबंधित है. एंड अलॉन्ग विद दैट थ्री एडजस्टमेंट हैज बीन देयर. फर्स्ट वन इज प्रोवाइड फॉर कॉन्टिंजेंसीज 2 लाख, ट्रांसफर टू रिजर्व्स 15,57,000, एंड लास्टली transfer 2 lakh to central government. These are the certain adjustments which have been given along with the trial balance, and we have been asked to prepare P&L account. So this is the format of P&L account which is constant for every question. It is not going to change. First one portion would be of income, interest on 13, that is second one other income 14. We have to get the total of first, then second one would be expenditure, first item interest expended or interest paid schedule number 15, and operating expenses schedule number 16, contingencies and provisions no schedule number, direct annual total. Then we would make the total and then we would calculate the profit by deducting 1 from 2, and we would get our net profit or net loss whatever applicable, and later on previous year profit would be provided to you in the question, either in trial balance it may be named in the name of profit of previous year or P&L account opening balance or previous year profit. Then fourth part would be of appropriation. First thing they have said, the statutory reserve 25% compulsory. That is what I have written, 25% year, whatever may be the amount of our profit of current year, it would be multiplied by it. Then transfer to other reserve, which is given in the adjustment, transfer to central government, again given in the adjustment, and later on the balance is to be transferred to balance sheet. For forming this solution, we have to prepare schedules as we have discussed earlier. So we would prepare 4 schedules, 13, 14, 15, 16. Interest, interest earned, other income, interest paid, other operating expenses. So we would first of all start with the schedule number 13, that is interest earned. So in it, we would take first thing as an part of our pro forma. What are the interest income given in the question? First one is the interest on loans. What is the amount? Remember one thing related with the amount, I would like to give you a note. In the question, the amount is given is like 250, 270, 1250, and in the what we can say pro forma portion, this term is given. It means that it is in thousands. So we would write everywhere denoting it कि जो भी अमाउंट दिया गया वो थाउजेंड्स में दिया गया. एज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द बैंकिंग, द वॉल्यूम ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन इज क्वाइट लार्ज, द वैल्यू ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन इज लार्ज, दैट इज व्हाई दिस काइंड ऑफ डिनोशन इज यूज फॉर दिस पर्पस. सो वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग, इंटरेस्ट ऑन लोन, इट इज गिवन फॉर रुपीज 2590. इफ आई वुड राइट इन द डिटेल्ड अमाउंट, इट वुड बी 2590 प्लस 30 एडिशनल. So the amount, the interest on loan would be 25,90,000. So that is why 000 has been given for reducing the length of the amount. That is the first thing, that is interest on loan. Second thing is interest on cash credit, that is interest on CC loan. I would write short, in short CC. The amount of loan is 2230. That is what is the interest earned by the bank. Remember one thing. Next is the interest on overdraft. That is OD. What is the value of the interest of overdraft? It is 1540. Last one is the discount on bill receipt. We have said that along with the interest, discount on bill should be taken here. Discount on bill discounted. That is what is the again income of bank. What is the value of it? Again the value is 1060. We have to make the total of it. The total would be 040. Seven four two zero. Now, as soon as we have made the total, we can transfer it into the P&L account. That is 7420. That is what is our total for schedule number from schedule number 13. That is interest earned. Now, next thing would be schedule 14. Other income. With regard to other income, what is given in the question? For other income, only commission received is given for rupees 82. That is 82,000. So we would write commission 82, and we would make the total as 82, and we would transfer it here. So 82 Now we would make the total of all the incomes, that is 7502, or else I can also call it as we have discussed earlier, 7502 plus 30, that is 75,02,000. That is what is the income of what we can say Prakti Bank for this financial year ended on 31st of March 2003. Now we will move to the expenditure part. First thing is the interest expended. What the interest bank has paid to it, we would write it here. Schedule 15, interest paid or interest expended, we can write either of the term. So for that we would see what are the items which are given in the question, which is attached in the link of the video. You can refer to it. So what are the interest expenses which are been given in the question? Very first is the interest on FD, that is fixed deposit. Interest paid on fixed deposit. The amount of interest is 3170, that is 31,70,000. Second one is the interest on savings bank deposit. Interest on savings bank deposit. The amount of interest for savings bank deposit is been given for rupees 680, that is 680,000. That is 3850. That is the two things which are been given with regard to this, and the total of both expenditure is 3850. That is 38,50,000 for the bank. Now second would be operating expenses. That would be from schedule 16, operating expenses. Remaining all expenses apart from the interest would classify in this term. So first one is the payment to employees for rupees 540 or 5,40,000. Payment to employees 540,000. Second, director fees, allowances, director fees, comma, allowances. The amount of director fees and allowances is given in the question for ₹3,030. Then rent, taxes and lighting. Rent, taxes and lighting. The amount of rent, taxes and lighting has been provided for ₹180. That is 180. Then postage, telegram and telephone has been provided for ₹14,000. Postage, telegram, 14,000. As we have taken the form, reduce the size of the values, hence we would write 1414. Then auditor fees, 12,000. Auditors fees, 12,000. We would write 12 as we have reduced the amount. Then printing and stationery, 29 rupees. Well, that is 29,000. Whatever the criteria you have used for forming the solution or what is given in the question should be taken into this account. Then last thing is given, sundry charges, that is 17. Sundry charges, 17. These are all the expenses which have been given in the question. Now we will make the total of it. So the total is 822 or 822,000. We would transfer it to P&L account, 822. Apart from this, we have to see is there any provision or contingencies given in the question. Definitely there is provisions or contingencies given in the question. The adjustment says that we have to provide for contingencies ₹2 lakh. As we have taken the thing that the value would be reduced by 30, therefore for 2 lakh we would write it as 200. Now this is all for the expenditure account. Now we can make total, that is 4872. This is what is our total of expenditure. Income was of 7502 and expenditure is for 4872. Therefore now we can we are able to calculate our net profit, as the income is more than expenditure. So 1 minus 2, that is 7502 minus 4872. Therefore our profit is for ₹2630. But the question doesn't have any previous year profit, that is why it would be termed as nil. Therefore the total would be 2630. That is what is the total of our profit of current year. Now moving to the appropriation. In appropriation, various times I have repeated in the video, even though that for adjustment, if there is not given the provision for statutory reserve, even after that we have to give statutory reserve at the rate of current year profit for 25%. That is 25% of 2630. 25% of 2630, that is equals to 658. Along with this, there is in the adjustment, there is a second adjustment that we have to transfer to other reserves for rupees 15,57,000. Therefore, three zeros apart, 15,57,000, that is 1557. This is what is transferred to other reserve. Transfer to other reserves, 15,57,000. Then we have to take transfer to central government, the amount of rupees 2 lakh has been said we should transfer to central government, therefore it would be 2 lakh. And as we have discussed when we were talking about the pro forma of P&L account, the total the balance we have to calculate on the basis of the total of the third, that is profit and loss account. The total of profit and loss account was 2630. Therefore 2630 minus 658 minus 1577 minus 200, that is 215, would be transferred to balance sheet in schedule number 2, that is reserves and surplus. The balance carried on to balance sheet is 215. This is what is our balancing figure. This is our balancing figure. How we get this figure? We have total. How we get this total? We get the total from third point, that is from profit and loss. We have get the same total here, and that total has been used for calculating the balance transferred to balance sheet. This is it for this video. Try to solve the problem after repeating and seeing this video. Take screenshot of the solution. If you have any kind of difficulty, you can contact me. And kindly go thoroughly through this solution if the exam is going to happen in either way. If it is in MCQ, then again we would need these schedule numbers, what items are belonging to which schedule. All these things would be required to us. So kindly go thoroughly with this video and understand how we have prepared the profit and loss account for the banking companies. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you.